Everybody, thank you for being here. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe and drop the video a like if you enjoy it. It would be great to have you here. In today's video, we are only going to be eating at food courts. Might not sound too appetizing to you, but I guarantee you we are in for some very good food, starting with one of our favorite places ever. If you remember a few videos back, we let Instagram choose our diet, and the two options we gave them was a place called Benchwarmers Bagels or New York Deli, and you chose New York Deli, and it was pretty awful.
The rich homies let me know.
So I've been dying to go back to Benchwarmers. It is, I would say, some of the best food in North Carolina. What do you think? Yeah? I haven't found a place that I like better. So their bagel sandwich is perfect. It's at a place called Transfer Food Hall. Now to me, that's the same thing as a food court. I think Megan thinks food hall is a little bit, you know, better, higher scale. But either way, Transfer Food Hall is amazing. It's got all types of different restaurants. If you're ever in Raleigh, North Carolina, definitely check it out. It's one of the most beautiful creations I've ever seen in my entire life. I got the plain bagel with egg and ham, and Meg got the plain bagel with bacon and egg. Am I even speaking correctly right now? I can't even, I'm so excited about this bagel sandwich right now. I'm telling you, it's 11 out of 10. You don't even need my review if you've watched previous videos.
What's your review on that?
Delicious.
Better than New York bagel?
Absolutely delicious, guys. The one thing I'll say though is that I think I prefer the everything bagel. This is my first time getting the plain. It's good, it's just not as soft and as perfect as the everything. So if you come here, I'll probably recommend everything bagel, scrambled egg, ham, cheese, you'll be good to go.
Benchwarmers, I think this is our favorite spot ever.
Yeah, I love it. Everything about it, it's just very aesthetic here. You can come hang out, you can drink some coffee, you get some good food, any food you can possibly imagine. Transfer Food Hall, best in the business. All right, my friends. So before we hit the gym, if I can get this ice, I'm gonna get stuck in here. We are gonna make ourselves a little cold brew smoothie. So I found this at the store. I wanted to share this with you guys. If you like the blonde roast espresso from Starbucks, this right here is gonna be your best friend. So they have the blonde roast cold brew, which this whole thing is like $5. So if you're trying to be cheap like me, then you don't have to spend a whole lot of money, and then you can just dump it in your shaker cup. And let me show you the absolute necessary step before you blend this together. You are gonna wanna add your PE Science Select Cafe. So this guy right here is jam-packed with so much flavor. It has 20 grams of protein, 100 milligrams of caffeine, and it just makes your coffee so delicious. So you're gonna put that in there, you're gonna blend it all together like so. You're also gonna wanna get your metal hippie straw, and then, oh my gosh, it's like a coffee smoothie right there. 12.25 out of 10. If you guys didn't know, you can always save 15% using Travis at PEScience.com. I'm gonna have this. Then we're gonna hit high rep legs today.
Cameraman, where are you going? Where are you going? Why aren't you here?
Getting my nails done.
Oh my gosh. Thank you.
Okay, guys, I am at a place that I absolutely despise, and that is the mall. In my opinion, there is no reason to ever go to a mall unless you have to shoot a video where you're eating only at food courts. And if you didn't know, the mall's got a pretty stellar food court, at least I assume. I've actually never been to this one. This is the Crabtree Mall here in Raleigh. And to make it even more exciting, it's what, 2-3 weeks before Christmas? So you know there's just a bunch of crazy people all around going to all these different stores and shopping. And I'm like, why? You could just go to movement.com, pick someone up a nice watch, save 15%, get free shipping and free returns, but we're gonna talk about that a little bit later. For now, I've just got to get to some food. Now, one to simply not come to the mall and not get a Cinnabon. Just look at that beauty right there, all 900 calories of it. Now, is it worth it? I would say absolutely. Here we go. 12.62 out of 10. Unbelievable. This all reminds me back in college. We used to go to this place called Fairfield Commons in Beaver Creek, Ohio. We would just do like 3 or 4 laps around the food court, get all of the samples of the Chinese chicken, and we'd be good. We wouldn't have to spend any money. Those were the days. But with that said, if you go to a food court, you have to get Chinese or Japanese chicken, rice, egg rolls, all that good stuff, and maybe even Auntie Anne's if I could find one. So we walked outside to try to get a thumbnail. It is hard doing this without cameraman. I miss her a lot. She's getting her nails done right now. Check this out. We got a pepperoni pretzel, basically just because I thought it'd be a good picture, but I'm sure it's gonna taste amazing as well. One bite, everybody knows the rules. This exceeded my expectations. You still get the amazing Auntie Anne's pretzel, which is just an absolute gift by itself. And then you throw a little bit of cheese, a little bit of pepperoni on there. This right here, honestly, is probably like a 9.4 out of 10. Maybe I should start eating at food courts. All right, guys, we are taking this one to go. I have had enough mall for about the next 6 or 7 years of my life, but we did get some pretty amazing food, so not all is lost in this trip. Oh yeah, what looks better? That amazing Japanese teriyaki chicken or those pretty nails? I'm gonna go with the nails. Cameraman, did you miss me? And if you guys saw the video where we went to all of those food trucks, I did try dumplings for the first time there, but those were like steamed or a lot different than this. What is this, fried?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. My first time ever having this. That's amazing. She's watching a show about a yogi rapist or something. I don't know. So the one thing that I learned over the last few hours is eating at the mall is a lot more fun than shopping at the mall. And I get it, it's the holiday season, everybody is out buying people gifts, when in reality, you can get on your computer, go to a few websites, and be done. That is why I am so excited that Movement has been nice enough to sponsor this video. You guys know I've been wearing Movement watches for many years now. I love the way they look. They're extremely sleek, they're very fashionable, and they start around $95. So you are not going to have to break the bank at all. You can buy things for your girlfriends, your boyfriends, your aunts, your uncles, your parents. Everybody needs a nice looking watch, right? And they have more than watches on their site. So I'd highly recommend you guys go over there, check it out, and in addition to the already low prices, you get an additional 15% in free shipping and free returns going to movement.com/Travis. All of that is going to be linked down below. I love the products, I love the company, and I can assure you that if you buy them for someone that you love, they will be very, very thankful for it, and they will like what you got them. It's very hard to find something that someone doesn't already have or something that they actually want. So go to movement.com/Travis, additional 15% off, free shipping, free returns, and you can thank me later. Okay, we have one more place to go for this day of food halls or food courts or whatever it is that you want to call it. And this is one of my all-time favorites, even though I guess I've never technically eaten there before. But when I go there, it's almost like Whole Foods, and the Whole Foods hot bar is amazing. What are you doing? You getting ready? Where are we going?
Wegmans.
Don't they have an amazing food court?
We don't know.
Doesn't it look amazing? Is what I mean?
Yeah.
The food there is amazing. Their sushi's amazing. Their groceries are amazing. How could the food at the food court not be amazing?
We shall see.
We'll find out. So Wegmans. That is a very, very nice place. Not your average food court. Some might not even consider it one, but I definitely would. It has a whole lot of options. So the first thing that we got here is a sub. So everyone is telling me I needed to get a sub from Wegmans, and today is the day. I got roast beef, ham, and turkey with some peppers and lettuce and cheese. You know what? We're just gonna give them a bite real quick. This is real time activity right now. That's a solid sub. This is better than almost every sub place that I've been to. If you're ever at a Wegmans, you can definitely count on the subs. And then over here, that's my favorite thing to do, is just go get a little bit of everything. So it's a little bit random, but stick with me. We got some amazing looking chicken tenders, some potato fries, one chicken wing, and butternut squash. I don't know if it's roasted in like oil or what.
That's amazing. And then these guys,
I feel like a child, but just one of my favorite foods. You can tell these are getting towards the end of the night.
But hey, still edible. You know what, I'm gonna put cameraman on the spot right now, because I got a DM after I uploaded today's video.
It was her trying fast food for the first time. It was one of her lifelong friends saying she's come a long way because she only used to eat chicken tenders. So cameraman might be the health nut that you all know and love today. But at one point, she was just a chicken nugget fiend. Is that true?
Yes.
Cameraman is admitting that. Okay.
Babe, that's a new chicken tender.
I'm gonna eat in peace so we can watch Greenleaf season 4. This is one of my favorite shows of all time. It is stressful, don't get me wrong, but check it out on Netflix, it's awesome. And of course, the best food court of them all, the Fat and Weird food court. So we've got the Christmas cookies over here. So we have got the Naughty List, dark chocolate, always one of my favorites. This thing right here is so dense, I am pumped for this. It is the Yippee-Ki-Yay. And then this guy, I believe is gonna be Megan's favorite, the Filthy Animal. What a great movie.
All right, we are gonna slice into these beautiful creations. Oh yeah, that is super festive. This is gonna be, we're gonna just call this the Meg right here.
Oh yeah, you're gonna love that.
And then this guy right here, this is what I have been dying to try. This is, I believe, a gingerbread cookie. Oh,
life is good, guys. Life is good. I'm gonna take a picture for the gram. They should be following me on the gram if they're not already. They're missing out on some great content. All right, I just gotta give them a taste test of this one. I mean, we know that they're gonna be amazing. We know that you can save 10% using Travis at fatandweirdcookie.com, and they release every Sunday at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. Oh my gosh, it's filled with peanut butter. I love these cookies, man.
Okay, my friends, that is going to be the end of the video. Those cookies were delicious, by the way. Definitely snaggy, about 30 of those guys. Really appreciate you all for sticking around till this point. If you made it, leave a comment down below. You guys could have been doing anything, anything in the entire world, and you chose to spend a few minutes with us. Isn't that right? Megan says goodbye. It was awesome to see you guys as always, and we look forward to talking to you guys next time.